The sentinel node is the first lymph node that filters lymphatic fluid from the tissue surrounding a tumor. This means that when cancer spreads, the cancer cells may appear first in the sentinel node before spreading to other lymph nodes. A sentinel node biopsy is a surgical procedure used to determine whether cancer has spread beyond the primary tumor into the lymphatic system. It is most commonly used in evaluating breast cancer and melanoma. A sentinel node biopsy involves injecting a radioactive, often blue tracer, that helps the surgeon locate the sentinel nodes during surgery. The surgeon then uses a gamma-detecting probe to help localize sites of high radioactivity. The cancer and sentinel node or nodes are then removed and analyzed in a laboratory. If the sentinel node is free of cancer, the cancer has probably not spread to other nodes in the area, and removing additional lymph nodes is not necessary. If the biopsy reveals cancer, more lymph nodes might be removed. This procedure is called an axillary lymph node dissection and involves the removal of 10 to 20 nodes from the armpit to assess for the presence of cancer. If cancer cells are found in those lymph nodes, other cancer treatments will be considered. During a lymph node dissection, lymph vessels leading to and from the sentinel node are cut. This disrupts the normal flow of lymphatic fluid through the affected area, which may lead to an abnormal buildup of lymphatic fluid that can cause a swelling that is called lymphedema. Lymphedema may cause pain or discomfort, and the overlying skin may become thickened or hard. Approximately 20% of women who have had an axillary lymph node dissection will have lymphedema, compared with about 5% of those undergoing a sentinel node biopsy. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you want to see more of my videos where I explain various medical topics in an easy and understandable way, make sure to subscribe and hit the bell button if you want to get notified every time I upload a video.